Hello, my name is Dr. Paul Choi. I am the director of Los Angeles Endoscopy Center. I am also a fellow member of American Gastroenterological Association. In this presentation, I'll be discussing inflammatory bowel disease. Inflammatory bowel disease, or IBD, is a chronic inflammatory condition of the intestinal tract. It often develops in children and young adults, with more than 1 million individuals affected in the United States. Although the cause of IBD is unknown, genetic and environmental factors appear to be important in its development. There are two forms of IBD, including ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. Ulcerative colitis primarily affects the colon. Crohn's disease, on the other hand, can affect any part of the gastrointestinal tract, although the small intestine and colon are most commonly involved. Inflammation in ulcerative colitis tends to be diffuse, superficial, and always starts from the rectum. In contrast, Crohn's disease tends to be patchy and penetrating and usually starts near the distal portion of the small intestine called the ileum. In fact, deeper ulceration in Crohn's disease can sometimes lead to conditions such as abscess, fistula, and stricture. In ulcerative colitis, bleeding, usually in the form of bloody diarrhea, is the most common initial presentation. On the other hand, in Crohn's disease, crampy abdominal pain and non-bloody diarrhea are more commonly seen. Other symptoms associated with IBD include fever, fatigue, anorexia, and weight loss. Other organ systems that may also be affected include liver, joints, muscles, eyes, and even skin. In fact, due to diversity and complexity of symptoms, it is very difficult to make a definitive diagnosis of IBD simply based on symptoms. To make a diagnosis of IBD, a careful review of complete medical history, physical examination, and routine blood tests is necessary. In addition, colonoscopy, an examination of the large bowel, is often performed to inspect the inner lining of the colon. During colonoscopy, a sampling or a biopsy may be performed to further examine the tissue under the microscope. Radiologic examinations such as abdominal CT scan may also be necessary to establish the diagnosis. The treatment of inflammatory bowel disease is aimed at decreasing symptoms and inflammatory process associated with IBD. An initial treatment may include antidiarrheal, antibiotic, and mild anti-inflammatory agents such as mesalamine. As the disease advances, stronger medications, including steroid and immunomodulator, may become necessary. In more difficult cases, a new class of medication called biologics may be helpful. In selected refractory cases, even surgery needs to be sometimes considered. Thank you for listening.